following is a presentation of the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports.
The ACC was born out of change. The tournament, rich in tradition, was once a tobacco field battle for bragging rights, but has evolved into the greatest show of them all. And while the number of teams may have changed and many legends have come and gone, the drive to be king rages on. That will never change.
King of the jungle, hear me roar. Killer, here I come, let's go to war.
Here I come, yeah!
I've waited all my life to get out of the trenches. I'm ready to fight for what I believe you can steal from me. I'm gonna take that, gonna fill these trenches and stand up.
Time comes, it's gonna explode.
Wake up,
it's gonna unload.
I won't give up,
so unbelievable.
Cause here I come.
We are Pop People and DMC. You're watching the ACC Tournament right here on the ACC Network.
We are halfway through round two of the Atlantic Coast Conference Tournament. Welcome back to Tournament Town. The state fans are in the house, and Mrs. Wolf and Ibis, the mascot for Miami, ready to go at it. It is the second round, the evening session, game three, ready to go tonight. And NC State brings with them the ACC's player of the year, T.J. Warren. Going up against him will be Ryan Brown. He's the scoring leader for Miami. This should be a good matchup. State going for its 20th win of the year, taking on the 11th seed, Miami. Both these teams actually won on each other's home court during the regular season. Hi, folks. Mike Hogwood here, along with Corey Alexander. I'm really looking forward to this game.
Well, and you mentioned each team won on each other's home court. They also won doing the other team's style. Miami, 85 points in Raleigh, and NC State was able to win, only scoring in the mid-50s at Coral Gables.
Well, we've got two games already in the books today. Florida State, Maryland, what a game that was.
Well, and it was a great game, and of course, it coming down to a game-winning dunk by Boris Bojanowski to take the Seminole into a bar tomorrow with a date with Virginia.
And then Pitt, really not even close against Wake Forest.
And from the tip, Pittsburgh was the aggressor, and they did it behind Lamar Patterson, getting it done on many different facets of the game, and the Panthers will advance tomorrow to see the Tar Heels.
And then we take a look at the brackets. The first half of quarterfinal Friday's already set.
And you think about the fact that Syracuse and Duke still are waiting to see who they will play. They're tuned in tonight to find out who their competitors will be tomorrow evening.
All right, a lot of excitement yet to be heard from tonight. And let's hear it right now from the guys who will call the game for you, Tim Brando and Dan Bonner.
All right, fellas, thank you so much. And Dan, Eric Swope came off the bench and ignited Miami yesterday. He's been in the last six games, double digits. He's been a real factor and has willed this Miami team into this round.
Tim, I think he's one of the reasons why Miami has gotten better, because Eric Swope is a guy who throughout his career has not been known as a great offensive player, a great athlete to be sure, and he has certainly made some spectacular plays in this tournament.
The rest of the Food Lion lineups, you'll see LeCompte, the outstanding freshman sensation, to go along with Darius Adams, who has to play big. That's the long and short of it with this team that completely revamped itself with older players and transfers. And T.J. Warren is the player of the year in the Atlantic Coast Conference, and he has been special.
Well, he's the long and the short of it for North Carolina State. He's averaging 34 points a game over his last five games, has scored more than 30 in four of those games. He has got to have a great game.
Vandenberg and Washington, the freshman along the front line. Ralston Turner, the only other double-digit scorer, will be joined by Tyler Lewis in the backcourt. Cat Barber will be coming in off the bench. The Hurricanes look to advance another day. NC State would like to get off the bubblicious line and make a run all the way to the finals.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by
AT&T, exclusive wireless provider of the ACC. By your Carolina Ford dealers. By Ruby Tuesday, official corporate champion of the ACC. By Food Lion, official supermarket of the ACC. And by Hyundai.
Greensboro, North Carolina, beautiful Chamber of Commerce sunset outside as we get ready for the nighttime session. Tim Brando alongside Dan Bonner as we get ready for the Miami Hurricanes and the Wolfpack of North Carolina State. The third member of our broadcast team, you'll hear from her quite a bit tonight, Deb Antonelli.
Well, guys, Tyler Lewis is the starting point guard for NC State. He leads the ACC in assist turnover margin. He also is fourth in the nation in that category. Good point guards know the answers to these three questions: who to get it to, when, and where. For NC State, the answer happens to be the same guy, DJ Warren.
Indeed.
And Deb, wouldn't the answer when be all the time?
I suspect that is in fact the case. Lewis struggled a little bit with his perimeter shooting earlier in the year, but he has been a great ball distributor. There have been times when he's ignited this team. Cat Barber, when he comes into the game, will drive it to the basket. Lewis will distribute the ball. So it's a completely different look when Barber is in there.
Well, we've got, it looks like a box and one against TJ Warren to start. Ryan Brown is matched up against TJ Warren.
Vandenberg looks down low for Washington. Nice job of corralling it on the blocks. Vandenberg can hit that shot. This time it falls short. That is a shot that he can make. He had some good moments along about midseason, and they got some quality post play from him. He's got the length, and he's been a bit more nimble this year offensively since midseason.
Well, he's lost 40 pounds since the last season, and so that certainly helps. And yeah, Tim, he can make that shot, but I think Miami would be very satisfied if they could get him to shoot that one many times.
Yeah, I'd say boxing one in the first sequence worked. Warren did not get a touch. Chikiri, not this time. Warren brings it down.
You'll see NC State try to push the ball, trying to beat that defense down the court.
Austin Turner could shake up that box and one. If he can get warm, he's the other threat from the perimeter, the primary threat other than TJ Warren. Lewis, long rebound is corralled by Adams.
So far, I think Miami's defense has accomplished what they want to. They've got guys other than Warren shooting the ball.
Adams drove it too deeply, pressed the issue, and turned it over. Miami really did it with mirrors this year in many ways to get eight conference wins after losing all of that talent from that run to the Sweet 16. Ralston Turner, right on cue, drains the tray, and that will impact what Jim Larrañaga wants to do with this box and one philosophy against the Wolfpack.
Well, Tim, that's two times in a row now they've been in the man-to-man, and Ryan Brown that time ran into a screen, and that's what got Turner open, and Brown limped up the court.
Swope lost it out of bounds. It's control to NC State.
Ralston Turner is going to come all the way across, and watch the screen right here by Vandenberg. That really ties up Ryan Brown. He can't get through it. Looks like he may have hurt himself a little bit. And Ralston Turner, as you mentioned, a dangerous three-point shooter.
Well, they're going to make NC State think, that's for sure. Larrañaga, one of the outstanding bench coaches in the country. He's been around the ACC since his days with Terry Holland's staff and Dave Odom as an assistant coach, as you see that one fall for Kyle Washington.
And Washington has developed into a very good mid-range jump shooter kind of offensive player. He's got a nice little left-handed hook around the basket. He is capable of putting up pretty big offensive numbers.
Pack leaded by five here in the early going. LeConte
fouled by Vandenberg. And let's take a look, Dan, at your four keys to the game tonight.
Keep in mind that when Miami beat North Carolina State the last time, they had five different guys in double figures, and I think that's what they need tonight. They've got to score. It's got to be all hands on deck. They've got to have contributions from anybody. And North Carolina State, they have that big player. He's got to have a big game.
Nice look inside off the inbounds pass. And it goes for Eric Swope. It's 5-2. First bucket of the night for the Canes, and it comes beyond the three-minute mark, deep into this first half. Jim Larrañaga, he just about wrapped up every National Coach of the Year honor you could get a year ago. The AP, the Naismith, the Basketball Writers, the Iba, the Rupp, the ACC, you name it. He got it a season ago, and deservedly so. Florida State a winner at the buzzer. Bojo got it done. A beautiful pick and roll action that was designed for Ian Miller earlier today to get Florida State into the next round. There's Warren, too strong. Vandenberg on the offensive glass. Keeps it alive. Warren cleans it up.
One of the ways that you become a great scorer, and that's what Warren is you just keep fighting for the basketball. He missed the three. He's made himself a decent three-point shooter, but he is a great offensive rebounder.
Darius Adams. Turner, quick outlet. Warren snuck out. Snowbird action. And the foul. TJ got away. It was a wonderful pass from Turner to go the length of the floor the way he did. Ryan Brown will pick up the personal for Miami.
One of the ways you get a fast break like this started is a great outlet pass, and certainly TJ Warren is a guy who knows how to finish in transition. That's an easy dunk except for the foul by Ryan Brown.
Think about all of that talent from a season ago and the great expectations that Mark Gottfried had after his first few years and taking his team in his initial season all the way to the Sweet 16 with a veteran group. Last year, I think the expectations were tremendous, and sometimes trying to share the ball with all of that talent became problematic. Well, much of it left, and TJ Warren was able to emerge into the kind of player that he and his family had always thought he would be.
NC State in the man-to-man.
Brown. Warren, the long rebound.
Well, you got to stop him.
In the open floor with the in-between game. A lost art in today's college basketball. Well, he's got five of NC State's 10.
You cannot let him get going with a full head of steam. You've got to make him pick up the ball before he gets to that three-point line area.
Marcon looking for some help. All 5'9½ of him. And that's a walk. Brown moved the pivot foot a bit too quickly. Well,
Vandenberg kept it alive. You're going to be the player of the year. Sometimes you got to outwork the competition. And TJ did just that.
All right, Dan, let's take a look at the AT&T Fast Analysis.
Well, we talked about TJ Warren, and one of the things that Miami's going to have to be able to do is defend him. There they make him give up the ball. But if you're going to defend him, you got to defend him all the time. That means blocking him out and stopping him in transition. He is really good at the mid-range game, and he can shoot tough shots.
And you see the player of the year, 24.8, would join Grant Duncan as the third player to lead ACC players of the year in both categories. That is some very tall company. State with 6 of its 10 points in the paint.
And Eric Swope is the guy who's matched up against Warren, trying to keep the ball away from him. Ryan Brown now matched up against Kyle Washington. Now he switches.
Turner again.
Boy, what a great block out by Eric Swope.
Yes, it was.
Part of defending TJ Warren is keeping him off the boards because he's an outstanding offensive rebounder, and Swope certainly did that.
Yes, he used all of the derriere. Swope with a sweeping move to the baseline, strong off the glass.
This is the guy, Tim, you mentioned. He's averaged almost 14 points a game over his last six games. His career average is 2.5 points a game.
And Washington, that may be a little quick for that jumper.
And right away, Mark Godfrey looks to his bench. And Anthony Cat Barber, the freshman from Hampton, Virginia, will get in. Won't fall for the Canes early. Darius Adams, he is struggling, as is Ryan Brown early on. Warren, whirling dervish would not fall. It fell halfway through the cylinder and back out.
Yeah, but he can make those kind of shots. You simply cannot allow him to get up a full head of steam with the basketball headed into the lane in transition.
This kid right here has been strong of late. There's another fantastic move by Swope. He's playing at a level that the rest of the Canes need to get to. If he gets the kind of help necessary, then Miami could be in for the long haul. He's got all six, and Debbie's got more.
Guys, that is exactly the key to the game for NC State, containing dribble penetration. The last two possessions, Swope goes right to the rim.
Turner again. He rattles it home. The LSU transfer now has six.
Yeah, but if you're NC State, though, don't you have to defend Swope by making him shoot the jump shot?
Make him go left or make him pull up. If he gets to his right hand, Dan, he's too strong.
And if you're Miami, you got to defend Ralston Turner in that three-point shot.
Brown taking it right at Washington and Vandenberg, and Kyle Washington picks up the personal.
Tim, and this is just what Debbie was talking about. Eric Swope, he's able to go to his right, and he is big and strong, and he can get up off the court. Now, again, he spins back to his right and drives the ball to the basket. He's just too powerful on the inside for Washington.
Ryan Brown had scored 20-plus points in his last 12 regular season games, but he did struggle in yesterday's game, was 3 of 13 from the floor and 2 out of 10 from three-point range.
As I said, Swope is playing at such a high level. If Brown can get his game up to where it normally would be, Dan.
Well, you saw Brown right there. He had 15 points against Virginia Tech. Swope had 14, and that's the kind of offensive effort we're talking about from those guys, but from their teammates as well. Tanya Jakiri, the last time these two teams played, had 15 points and 13 rebounds, so they're going to need a contribution from him as well.
Warren. Not there. Brown with the rebound for Miami.
Manu Lacan.
Davon Reed now in the game, and he's matched up against TJ Warren.
So many guys playing really out of their normal positions. This guy can play as big as you need anyone to. Jakiri had it, but lost it. Vandenberg recovers, gets it into the hands of Barber. And he can go. Beep, beep. Look out. Right to the 10. Can't get it to fall. Warren trying to keep it alive. Finally run down by Vandenberg and a fresh 35.
Little bit out of control by Barber, but once again, there's Warren. He's always going after the basketball. He didn't get that offensive rebound, but he sure helped his teammates get it.
Freeman set a pick. Warren could not get the teardrop to fall. And we've got a whistle underneath. Foul spotted against Miami. Timeout. Wolfpack lead by 5.
The ACC tournament is special because of the tradition, the coaches, the players, the history. When you go back and watch over the years, great plays, great moments. I think college basketball in America, I don't know that there's a better place come tournament time than the ACC tournament.
That from a Midwesterner out of Crestline, Ohio. His father, Joe, was a head basketball coach, later became the athletic director at South Alabama. He went on to play for Wimp Sanderson, outstanding guard for a team that went 16-2 in the 80s, went to 4 straight Sweet 16s. And there you see the profile on his team. I think for the time he was hired by WEL, he was the right fit at the right time to bring North Carolina State back, Dan.
The time he's in right now, I think his team needs to win this tournament if they're going to the NCAA. That record against the top teams, not really very good.
I would disagree. I think if they beat Syracuse and Duke, which would get them to the finals, would get them an at-large bid.
course, it all depends on who else is in the pool and what the results of other tournaments are.
Absolutely. I agree with that.
I'm glad you agree with me on something. You can disagree with me for two nights.
It's outside your control when you're in the position of teams like State, Clemson, obviously. And a shot clock violation waiting to happen that time for the Wolfpack as a good defensive sequence for Jim Larrañaga's club. I think this card, though, this is a perfect draw for NC State. You want to play teams that are top 50 RPI teams, and the draw is perfect. They get a possible rematch with Syracuse. They gave one up against them that they feel they should have had, and that's a moving pick against Jaquiri. And Deb has more on the NC State huddle during the timeout.
So much energy over here on this side of the floor, guys. Coach Godfrey talking about crash the glass hard, and he said all week we've been telling you about Swope. You've got to make them go left. Keep them out of the middle of the floor.
And they haven't been able to do that, Deb. That's why Swope, he's got three field goals. He's the only guy that's got them. NC State half-court offense runs better with Tyler Lewis playing the point. Yeah. The transition offense might run a little bit better with Cat Barber running the point.
Absolutely. Out of bounds, says Brian Kersey. It belongs to North Carolina State underneath their own hoop.
And as we watch the battle inside, D.J. Warren in the middle of it. Freeman is the one who was struggling with the ball, but Warren got his hand on it as well. It is really a task to try to keep Warren away from the ball.
North Carolina State won for its last nine from the floor, which may be one of the reasons Barber got into the game. They were hoping to get some penetration and maybe get some easier buckets near the basket. They got six of their first 10 inside the paint.
And Anya in the game now for Jordan Vandenberg.
Lee working on the smaller defender. LeConte draws the foul, the first on Manu. Fourth team foul. And Darius Adams will check in for Jim Larrañaga. Anthony Cat Barber. Looking for some openings inside. And off the ball, we've got a little action on T.J. Warren defensively. Reed trying to stay with him, and he'll pick up the foul. That's his second.
You know, if you're going to stay with T.J. Warren, when the ball goes to the other side of the court, you have to get off. Now, the ball's on the other side of the court. You cannot play T.J. Warren that way. You've got to get off and get in the middle to anticipate that cut. There's pretty good job by Miami forcing North Carolina State to call a timeout. But staying with T.J. Warren doesn't literally mean you stand right next to him all the time, particularly when the ball's on the other side of the court.
Absolutely. 9:38 remaining. And a reminder, don't forget coming up next. Last night's winner, the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets, had to fight hard through a few clock issues and power outages to earn its way to take on the paws of the Clemson Tigers, another team that finds itself on the tournament bubble, very similar to the situation NC State faces. Probably need a run to the finals to get their way in, and KJ McDaniels is one of the outstanding three men you'll see in college basketball.
And these two teams, they met twice during the regular season, Clemson winning both times in games that were defensive struggles.
That's being kind, actually.
I'm a kind of guy.
Dave Odom and I at the game at Clemson. It was 45-41. Clemson winning. And neither team could really find the ocean that night. But both have outstanding defenses. Barber cannot get the floater to go. And the drought continues for NC State. One for their last 10 from the floor.
Miami really hasn't been able to take advantage. North Carolina State doing a great job switching screens out front. That time, though, a cut off the ball. North Carolina State just lost track of Garius Adams.
So he'll get the hoop with the harm from Barber, his first. The 2014 ACC Legends will be honored at a brunch on Saturday. It's a wonderful event. Ike Hogwood's very involved with that. For tickets and more information on this year's Legends, visit theacc.com and search Legends. Players like Gene Banks, love him. former teammate of Mike Jaminski, Tree Rollins, John Lucas, Travis Best, Eric Montross, and Dave Bing, also former Virginia head coach, Terry Holland. That's all on Saturday. I attended it for the first time last year, and boy, what a magnificent presentation that was. That room is filled with a lot of stories through a lot of generations of 61 years of the ACC tournament. Turner can't hit. Long rebound taken by Adams.
Nice job by North Carolina State to get back on defense. Miami doing a nice job pushing it up. I think the Hurricanes have to be willing to do that. When they have opportunities, they've got to get the ball down the court. Man-to-man defense for the Wolfpack.
Akabajori in the game set that pick. Still unable to get the shot off. Reed not there. And not one of your top options. Desmond Lee brings it down.
Yeah, but Reed is a guy who's capable of putting up some offensive numbers. He scored 15 points the last time these two teams played.
Which is interesting because both won on the other team's home floor and did it in sort of the contrasting styles to what stereotypically they each play. Lee, tough drive, strong move. Freeman is rejected. Both teams are grinding, and North Carolina State has been stuck on 13 for quite a while. Adams. Well, the last state field goal came at the 13:02 mark.
Darius Adams has shown himself to be a very effective point guard, particularly as a guy who attacks the basket. He gets to the free throw line an awful lot. You've got to make him a jump shooter.
Freeman whirling right into a double team, but there is a push inside. It'll go against Jacquari. Warren and Swope getting the job done for each of their teams as the Canes and Wolfpack get things going tonight in Greensboro. This is the ACC Network. It's an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. And Ruby Tuesday takes us around the ACC to check in on all of the conference action from earlier today. Maryland leaves for the Big Ten by going down in their second round matchup against Florida State. Seminoles, again, much like Clemson, and these NC State players are playing with a lot of anxiety with the hopes that they can get in off the bubble, and Pittsburgh just demolished Wake Forest in the second game today. Lamar Patterson was key to that victory.
Well, now like Manu Lacan is matched up against TJ Warren. You got to get him the ball.
Kanye gets the roll. Nice jump hook to make it 15-12.
Kanye not a big scorer, only 65 points on the season coming into the game.
In one of those rare situations where he's actually got a height advantage against the man he's trying to defend. That doesn't often happen for him, but trying to deal with a 5'9 LeConte right on cue, a pilfer and a deuce. 17-12 North Carolina State.
Defensively out on the perimeter, North Carolina State is switching every screen that Miami sets. And that time, Kelly found himself matched up against Barber, and Barber just waited till he dribbled it and took the ball.
NC State 7 points off turnovers, and alley-oop for Brown. Well judged by Adams, who made the pitch. He's got four. 17-14.
Not still matched up against Warren.
Tough take. That young man got caught in the wrong switch.
Tim, it wasn't a switch. He's been matched up against them the last two times down the court. And unless LeConte can take the ball away from Warren when he's dribbling it, there's no way he can even do so much as bother Warren once Warren rises up for a shot.
Brown not there. Are you concerned or curious as to why they haven't gone box in one again, or they just haven't needed to?
Now, Tim, it may have been just a misread on my part.
Well, I didn't think so. I thought they were in a box in one in that opening sequence. wouldn't be the first time that somebody hasn't chosen to go in that direction against a guy like Warren when you're averaging almost 25 a night.
Well, now we have a switch. Garius Adams at 6 feet six, a much better matchup from a height standpoint going against Warren right now.
Barber. Out of bounds. Deb Antonelli's got more. Deb?
Hey, guys, I think part of the reason why LeCon ended up on T.J. Warren the last couple of trips is because NC State is pushing it so hard in transition that that is the first matchup that LeCon could get. If they keep pushing it like that, I think T.J. Warren will be able to take advantage of those if NC State continues to move the ball quickly.
So therein lies, Deb, the reason why we're not seeing Lewis, we're seeing Barber in your judgment, huh?
That's exactly it. They want up-tempo. They want energy. That's what Coach Gottfried is asking from his guys in the huddles.
Akabajori was fouled on the way up. Well, or did you just lose it out of bounds? I'm sorry, there's no foul.
I think if I'm Manu LeCont, I'm going to look for another matchup. I don't want that matchup.
Yes, yes.
Even if that's the first one, I'm going to find a different one. I say, no, I'm going to pass on this one. I'll take another. It's like in one of those game shows, you pass.
Wait a minute, did we have a foul?
No, we didn't have a foul, but the ball never hit the rim, okay. So you've got a
clearing. The 33 was the seconds remaining on the clock.
Right.
Won't go for Brown. Tapped back out to Garius Adams. Brown's got it again. He drives baseline, jams it home. Counted in a foul. Boy, that was done with authority. Yeah, that's worth a chest bump. You name it. That was posturizing at its best.
Well, you're really concerned if you're P.J. Agnew about the three-point shot, and so you can't actually say Agnew got out there quickly. He sort of lumbered out there, and as soon as Brown saw that was Agnew, he went right around him. By the time Brown got going, nothing Freeman could do. That's as bad a mismatch, Brown against Agnew, as LeCont against T.J. Warren.
Well, it looks as though Swope is getting the help that he wanted from Ryan Brown early. And the game is on. Miami is here to stay, it would appear. Barber picked up his dribble. He's prone to do that in half-court sets. Freeman can't get the jump hook to go. That was a hard luck miss. Akabajori working that pick and roll, but they were unable to find him. Adams launches.
Boy, Swope just took that away from B.J. Agnew.
He did that all day yesterday in that comeback for Miami. Nice defensive work by Warren and a toss out. Great read. Barber to Freeman. It all began with the player of the year. On the deck, tapping it out, reading where his teammates would be.
Some miscommunication on the part of the Hurricanes, and Warren stepped right in the middle of it. He's more than just a scorer, as he showed you right there.
That's one of those you just don't see in the box score. Agnew may have had all ball there. That was close. Big fella got caught with a reach. Player of the year made quite a reach. And Reed. Slam time in Greensboro. Let's take a look at our Principal Financial Group edge to the game. And that's a big one. North Carolina State with 9 points off the turnovers. And that has enabled them the early lead. And here's
the last thing is North Carolina State doesn't have any turnovers. And Reed and Brown, they just get tied up. It's like they're talking to one another. Forget they're on the court. Nice job by Warren to pitch that ball ahead. And a really good job by Freeman to follow down the court. And Agnew, he's out of the game right now. And it just looked like he was so tired he couldn't get up and down.
Vandenberg has checked back in, as has Tyler Lewis. For North Carolina State out of the timeout. So Cat Barber also gets a blow after some quality work coming in off the bench.
Washington back in as well. I thought Freeman did a nice job coming in.
Really did.
Too.
Really did. Good energy.
Well, right, we've got a lost shoe. It's Lewis. Lewis has no shoe.
Slip, slide, and ride with Tyler.
Well, maybe you ought to try to drive him to the basket.
Wouldn't be a bad idea. He went right into a pick. And there's the putback by Akabajori. And Tyler's got a find a way to get his shoe back on.
Well, he's got to find it first.
Well, closed captioning for ACC basketball is provided by Bojangles, famous chicken and biscuits. It's bow time. Something's jangling on those tennis shoes right there.
The problem when you give up penetration like that, Lewis was really in trouble because it's hard to guard with only one shoe on.
Yeah, yeah.
But the defense comes to help out, and then nobody's available for blocking out, and as a result, you get offensive rebounds. There's Garius Adams matched up against T.J. Warren. Again, Adams 6'6", 6'7". He's a much better matchup in terms of being able to contest Warren when he shoots the ball. Warren from side to side looking for the ball. And Adams doing a great job denying it. That's really nice defensive work.
Shot clock down to 8. Lewis leaves it for Vandenberg. And did we have a shuffle? 3-second violation. Rarely seen. First turnover committed by North Carolina State. Jordan was in there a little too long.
Now the key to that whole possession was NC State decided they were going to T.J. Warren, and Garius Adams would not allow them to do it. You know, Miami has made a reputation for themselves playing zone this year, but we haven't seen the zone so far.
A lot of teams have turned to that. Brown forced the issue that time, and as a result, we'll get to the free throw line.
And Brown does a pretty nice job getting to the free throw line. You have to respect Brown's ability to shoot the three, and he makes you pay for that by putting the ball down and going to the basket.
Ralston Turner gets the foul, his first. Mike Hogwood and Corey Alexander will be busy at halftime with the Hardys halftime report. Update you on scores from earlier today in the ACC. Plus a look at the first half of our game. All of that on the Hardys halftime report. Reed takes a seat.
After a relatively quick start, Tim, the NC State offense has been moving along here lately in low gear.
Yeah. The Miami defense on Warren has been, they're making him work a lot to get free. He's had his moments, but he's had to work hard to get them.
They're giving a lot of help to whoever is guarding Warren, and that means you have to have opportunities for other folks.
As we mentioned it, the help came a little bit late that time, and as a result, a foul. Alcabajori will pick up the foul, his first.
There's no hesitation on the part of Warren. He gets the ball, he sweeps it right to the basket. You know, I think the best you can do, and Adams was trying to deny him the ball, and sometimes when you're trying to deny and you miss just by a slight instance, then that allows the offensive player to have a lane to the basket.
Eight points on the night for TJ. And you could tell that coming into this game and really the back half of the season, he wanted to get the most out of his collegiate experience that was afforded him by staying in school this past year. He had an opportunity to go elsewhere. LeConte working on the smaller Tyler Lewis. It's very rare that LeConte would say that. Here's Brown. That one was last touched by Manu LeConte, and it'll go over to North Carolina State.
That was a really good job by Turner to move his feet and prevent Brown not only from getting into deeply into the lane, but watch as Brown comes off here. It's a very odd angle to try to pass the ball to LeConte. And LeConte just stood there. When a guy drives into the lane, you've got to find a position from which you can do some damage. You can't just stand and watch.
Warren loves the contact. He really does. He's one of those guys that invites it and normally would make that shot. Foul goes against Adams, his first.
Well, that was interesting because that time the guy guarding Tyler Lewis just leaves Lewis. Warren is going to come to the top of the key and watch as Lewis goes over here. His guy stays, and as a result, you sort of have two guys on Warren, but he just waits till Ryan Brown leaves, and then he drives to the basket.
10 points off of the turnovers, really the difference in the game with the timeout taken by Miami with 53.8. 24-20 is our score. And let's take a look, Dan, at our Haviland defensive shield.
What we've been talking about are the turnovers, and Miami has 8 turnovers, as you can see. North Carolina State has turned those into 9 points, and not very hard to figure out the difference in the game when you look at those points off turnover numbers. North Carolina State, of course, with T.J. Warren, they're known more for their offense, but defensively, Cap Barber, we see him get the steal and then get down and get the basket, and then here's T.J. Warren coming up with the steal, pitches it ahead to Cap Barber, and North Carolina State, they have been very effective when they've been able to get out in transition, and here, fortunately for Miami, that's a turnover, but it's not one of those transition turnovers where North Carolina State has been able to get up and down.
Barber and Lewis both out of the game. And Deb Antonelli was around Jim Larinaga's huddle moments ago.
Yeah, Coach Larinaga wants to make sure that his team continues to attack the rim. They're doing a great job of that, but they need to stop fouling T.J. Warren. They're putting him to the line too much.
Yeah, they will get in foul difficulty late if that continues. And that's even with rotating different guys defensively on him. Swope took an extra step.
And again, that results. What did Debbie say Mark Godfrey told his guys? Don't let Swope go to his right. And that's exactly what happened right there. They made him go back to his left. And as a result, he walked. And now North Carolina State can take the last shot of this half if they so choose. Man defense for Miami.
Lewis will initiate at or around the 10-second mark. And again, a push against Warren, which is exactly what Deb was telling us about during the huddle, and Larinaga is beside himself. Goes against Garius Adams, and that's 2 on him. He joins Reed with 2 and Jakiri with 2.
And Adams is trying to be aggressive, and that's obviously North Carolina State's play is to get the ball to T.J. Warren and clear out, and Adams was trying to prevent him from getting the ball, but a little bit too aggressive.
Warren got to the free throw line coming into the ACC tournament 180 times this year. Converted on 128 of them. Lesson for all great players. If you're going to drive, you know you're going to get to the line. You had better convert. Lacotte working against Desmond Lee. And Desmond picked up the foul with 4.6 remaining. And it's 1-1 time.
And that's, as we've seen throughout the first half, that's been the Miami strategy. Attack, attack, attack.
Tyler Lewis will get back into the game for Lee, who's been about Lee's been sort of a mixed master player. You got to take the good with the bad for North Carolina State through the course of this season. At times can make some big plays, but also will take too many chances. Lewis is out there for that last opportunity at 4.6 with Lee sitting down. Larinaga gets all of the Canes off the line. Get them back defensively.
Now Warren's got plenty of time.
Yes, he does. And it's Lacotte that gets the covering. Not there, and we're at the half. North Carolina State came out warm. T.J. Warren, though, had to work very hard for every opportunity as Miami's defense, with many changing jerseys covering him, made it difficult for him to get loose. And Mark Godfrey is standing by with Deb Antonelli.
Coach, I got Miami shooting 0-for-5 outside of 15 feet. I got them 8-for-14 inside. How do you change your D?
Well, first thing is they've only scored 22 points. So even though they've scored around the rim, they haven't scored that many. And so we've done a decent job. We got to rebound the ball better. We've come over and tried to block some shots, and then we haven't rotated to block out the next guy. But that's their strength. We got to make sure we don't give that up in the second half.
And then are you getting enough touches for T.J. Warren?
I think so. You know, they're doing a good job of fronting him and denying him and, you know, making it hard for him. We've seen that all year. But he's going to be fine. It's going to come.
Thanks, Coach.
Okay.
Hey, back over to you, Tim.
You got it, Deb. A very confident Mark Godfrey going into the locker room, and he well should be. His team has only given up 22 points. Mike Hogwood, Corey Alexander coming up.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Ruby Tuesday, official corporate champion of the ACC. By Nissan. By Havoline, official motor oil of the ACC. And by Gatorade, official corporate partner of the ACC.
Hardee's presents the Hardee's Halftime Report, introducing the charbroiled Atlantic Codfish Sandwich. It's fish without the fry, only at Hardee's. Very low scoring first half. NC State on top by four. Mike Hogwood, Corey Alexander with you now. Corey, at one point in the half, NC State went 6 minutes. 6 minutes without a field goal, yet they lead it by four.
Well, Mike, this game follows a trend that we've seen from NC State and Miami all year in their series. NC State is winning a game at Miami's pace. This is the way that Miami wants to play, but we go to what we how we got here early today is Boris Bojanowski, who was able to finish for Florida State and get them a win, and he spent some time with our Debbie Antonelli afterwards. But before we got to that, we talk about Talib Zana and Lamar Patterson carrying Pittsburgh early today, and they face the North Carolina Tar Heels tomorrow in their matchup.
Yeah, that's what happened here earlier today, and you see those scores on our Nissan scoreboard. FSU moving on now to play Virginia, and it'll be Pittsburgh playing North Carolina tomorrow. Some other scores, Utah and Arizona. That in the Pac-12 tournament, and that was a lopsided win there. Speaking of lopsided, how about Louisville and Rutgers and some other scores? And as Corey said, it was a career game for Boris Bojanowski, and Debbie Antonelli had a chance to talk to Florida State star player.
Boris, take us through the last play.
I mean, we're on the ball screen. I roll. I was ready for the pass. They passed to Okoro. They double-teamed Okoro, and he found me, you know, so it was basically wide open dunk. So I was just ready for the opportunity.
Boris, all game you were a factor on the inside. You rebounded. You scored. Why were you ready to play today?
We knew it's a must win for us. You know, we're trying to get into NCAA tournament, so we got to win a couple games. So we was ready, and we came up hard.
You got a lot of minutes in the game tonight. How do you get yourself ready mentally and physically to play tomorrow?
Oh, we got to go back in the hotel, get some rest, get ready for Virginia tomorrow.
Thank you, Boris.
All right, thank you.
The hero today had 12 points and 12 rebounds for Florida State. Again, they'll play Virginia tomorrow. 26-22, our score here. Game three on day two of the 61st Atlantic Coast Conference Tournament. Corey and I will be back with more halftime in a moment. Four-point lead by NC State. And what is incredible about this first half, Corey, is almost half of the points, 12 of them by NC State, comes off of Miami turnovers. Wow.
And nine turnovers for Miami in the first half. And that's really fueled the offense for NC State. And Cat Barber getting involved in the defense early, getting out in the open court off of the steal. But it's not just Cat Barber. It's also the ACC Player of the Year, T.J. Warren, diving on the floor, coming up with a loose ball that turns into two more points for the Wolfpack. And NC State has gotten it done, not only that way, but keeping Eric Swope, who started out fast, but they bottled him up, not allowing him to get to the paint. It's been the defense for the Wolfpack that's carried him in the first half.
Well, Corey, we've got half of quarterfinal Friday already decided. Hey, I'm looking forward to that Georgia Tech-Clemson game a little later on tonight.
Well, you're talking about two good defensive teams, and they've had a couple slugfests early this year. I don't expect anything less than that here tonight.
You know, one thing that we've really enjoyed here, or I know the folks here have enjoyed, are the halftime shows. These guys can fly, man. And they are really putting on a show for the fans. Corey and I'll be back. More halftime coming up in a moment. Hey, do you like it? Rock and roll and hip hop mixed together. DMC and Pop Evil, they're helping us get through this tournament all the way through Sunday. Turnovers again have been the story. NC State up four, low scoring first half, 26-22. We're about ready to go with the second half, so we're going to send it back now. Two of the best in the business, Tim Brando and Dan Bonner. Fellas?
Yeah, we got rhythm, too, just like Hogwood. We're all about that rock and roll and hip-hop. Thank you, Mike. Listen, rocking and rolling and hip-hopping around has been difficult on T.J. Warren, but he still managed a dozen. It's not bad.
I think T.J. Warren's been very well defended by Miami, and he's only shooting the ball at a 3-for-9 pace, but he's a guy who works very hard. He can score points when he's having a tough shooting night because he gets offensive rebounds. He's got two of them in the game. He's really good in transition. You've got to stop him before he can get in a position like this to score in transition. And he's gotten himself to the free throw line 8 times and made 6. And Ryan Brown, he's the leading scorer for Miami. He's got 8 points, and he has also been able to score close to the basket and from the free throw line. Not much going for Miami. No baskets from beyond the 3-point arc.
And the Hyundai first half stats, again, it's been really the turnovers and the points off. And it could be worse for Miami than it really is, given the turnovers. Not as many live ball turnovers as turnovers in general, and that's huge. And it's a 12-1 run there.
Tim, look right there. Miami's not shooting the ball poorly, but you cannot turn the ball over 9 times. They're not getting that many shots.
Here at halftime, Miami looking to stop NC State's bid for a possible at-large in the NCAAs. They look to play larger in the second.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Toyota, official corporate champion of the ACC. By Hardee's. By GEICO, official corporate champion of the ACC. By BB&T, official bank of the ACC, member FDIC. And by 5-Hour Energy.
We welcome you back to the Greensboro Coliseum. Tim Brando alongside Dan Bonner. We're at halftime. North Carolina State leading Miami by 4. And our Deb Antonelli moments ago talked with Miami head coach Jim Larrañaga.
Coach, you're only down 4. You've turned the ball over 9 times. What do you need to do differently?
Not turn the ball over. We haven't in recent weeks. Been very few turnovers for us, but I think we're a little over-anxious to start the game.
Coach, you're working really hard to put all your efforts on containing T.J. Warren. How would you grade your effort? Might you change anything?
Well, you got to keep him off the foul line. It's not our defense. It's a, you know, when you get to go to the foul line, there's no defense on a free throw shooter.
Thank you, Coach.
One of those great fundamentals in coaching, right? Teaching your guys to defend hard without fouling, man.
Well, and also not to throw the ball to the guys in the white shirts when you're wearing orange.
Pretty simple. LeConte working against Lewis as we open the second half. Miami in possession. Nice head fake and ball fake by Brown. He got free from Turner and got the layup, 26-24.
And the NC State defense was trying to make some adjustments along the back line. And guys were switching around back there to eliminate some mismatches, and so nobody was available to help out.
I think this guy right here, 22 and white, is going to be a real key for NC State, Dan, in the second half, because Warren is going to be targeted. We know that. This is the guy that is the second option offensively, Turner, and he can light it up.
I think Washington here with the ball and Vandenberg have to be factors as well.
Lewis in traffic. That's a stressful shot that hit nothing. But a fresh 35 because possession did change hands. Miami had it. That could have been a violation had the ball not really been taken away inside by Jakiri, but it was. A real break for North Carolina State.
That was T.J. Warren that got in there and swept it away.
It was. Right as Jakiri got his hands on it. There's Warren, little give and go action of Vandenberg dishing it to the player of the year, and he's got 14.
He just did a great job using the screen by Washington to get himself open, and that's that constant movement without the basketball. It's really difficult to defend. NC State comes out in a little 2-3 zone.
Miami's had great success driving the ball to the basket, but little shooting from the perimeter, and that's what that zone is designed to do, is cut down on that penetration.
Turner deflected that one to get it into NC State's hands, and what a pass that time. Very subtle by Lewis to Warren to collect yet another bucket.
And the more subtle point there, Tim, than just the pass was the fact that Warren was able to pick that ball off the deck and get it headed toward the basket. Now steal.
Vandenberg rallied and stopped the alley-oop. Lewis with another Sunday best dish. This one to Washington. A full platter coming from Tyler. 32-24, and Larinaga gets a timeout.
The North Carolina State Wolfpack on a 6-0 run. T.J. Warren moving without the ball. And that's always a pretty good formula for success. Then Warren taking the ball to the basket. Jordan Vandenberg with the steal. North Carolina State with 6 steals in the game. That gets them off and running. And Washington with a nice catch and a nice move inside.
As we come back to live action, Swope is looking to get involved in this offensive sequence. Eric, a catalyst really the last half of the season for Miami, when they finished with a flurry in the ACC's regular season. As we said, with all their losses, to get 8 conference wins was quite an accomplishment, putting this team together the way they did. And there's Manu LeConte knocking down a tray. 32-27, he's got 5.
That's really the first basket in the game scored by the Hurricanes outside of the lane area.
Right.
Everything has been close to the basket.
Warren runs the curl past the Vandenberg pick, but Ryan Brown right there with him. Washington not there.
Just maybe a foot or two out of his range.
Adams, nice scoop to the hoop, but he can't finish. Washington had it. And it was pulled away by Jahiri.
North Carolina State stays in the zone defense. They're going to make Miami hit a couple of those from outside.
Jahiri off the feed from Adams. But a foul underneath. It will go against Vandenberg.
We mentioned that Jahiri in the last game between these two teams had 15 points and 13 rebounds. He only has 1 shot attempt in this game. Has handled the ball very infrequently. That time a nice pass inside. Now he is not a good free throw shooter.
No, he's only 56% at the stripe on the season. Good rotation there, though. They will go with Leonard Freeman coming in for Washington. One of the things Mark Gottfried has done this year, Dan, and at the beginning of the season, I don't know that he felt that he would get out of his front line what he has, but the combination of Anya Vandenberg kind of emerging this season to go along with Washington, he's sort of massaged that front line situation to get the best out of it that he really could to sort of help this team inside. Deb Antonelli has more on that.
Well, Tim, you're absolutely right. Vandenberg dropped 40 pounds. He committed himself to getting ready. He's motivated to help this team, but he also wants to play for future in his career. And we talked to Debbie Yao, the athletic director, before the game. She said, this is the perfect setting for Mark Gottfried. You pointed to this before, Tim. This is exactly what he does well, is gets his team in a right mindset to play in the postseason.
Well, that's the goal now. That foul does go against Warren, a player control foul. They're getting ready for action. KJ McDaniels and company are off the bus. You are watching the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. Hey, talk of legends, there's David Thompson, one of the all-time greats, the history of college basketball and at NC State. And there's Julius Hodge, another first-team All-ACC performer from 2003, and Deb Antonelli is with him.
Julius, when you watch NC State play, what memories does it bring back for you?
Just being here in ACC tournament is definitely an honor for me to be named an ACC legend. But seeing State play, it brings back good feelings, you know. I had a couple of heartbreaking losses, but it brings back mostly good feelings.
Julius, there's only been seven guys in the history of NC State basketball that have been named Player of the Year. You've been one of them. What do you think it's been like for T.J. Warren to try to keep his focus in this environment?
Well, Debbie, I think it's easy for him. You know, he's a very hardworking kid. He works extremely hard every day. He's a great guy, a very nice personality. So it's easy for a guy like him.
I know you've already thought of this, and you're probably going to get asked this at the luncheon's breakfast on Saturday. What's your best memory about playing at NC State?
My best memory about playing at NC State? Attaining my college degree. That was for my mom, and I'm so happy I've done it. Getting that education, I'm a much smarter man today because of it.
A fan favorite at NC State. Thank you, Julius.
Thank you.
I think he gave the right answer, Dan, don't you? He knows he's going to get the question. He gave exactly the right answer. And we've got a conversation going on with our officiating crew and apparently another clock issue. It stopped running during that sequence a moment ago. Our officials, Brian Kersey, Tim Nestor, and Tim Kelly taking a look at it. And they are going to check the replay to see, in fact, exactly where the clock stopped during that sequence.
We've had a couple adventures with clocks in the games that you and I have done so far.
It follows me like the snow. I don't know about you, but
misadventures do not follow me.
Good luck with your travels tomorrow. Yeah. Tonight's coverage of ACC basketball is broadcast on AFN, the American Forces Network, and we welcome the nearly 1 million men and women of the U.S. Armed Forces stationed around the globe in 175 countries and on the high seas. We're proud to have you with us and hope you're enjoying our broadcast.
Thank you.
Lots of love here in Greensboro, particularly in red tonight. And yesterday we had the first games played in quite a while on a Wednesday with the additional teams. But in a lot of respects, and there was an article written by a columnist in the Greensboro paper today, in a lot of respects, many people believe this was NC State's tournament from the get-go, going back to the Everett Case days. And in recent years, even during the Sidney Lowe era, prior to Mark Gottfried, the Wolfpack have performed very well in this building. Turner fouled as he made his move inside the painted area. It'll go against LeConte, his second.
And Turner is a guy who is noted, as you have mentioned a couple times, Tim, for his three-point shooting, but when he's guarded by LeConte, he uses that size advantage and takes the ball to the goal.
Oh, boy, the iron really unkind to Vandenberg on that tip drill after Warren missed the chippy.
Don't usually, even under heavy pressure, you don't usually see Warren miss one from point-blank range like that one. NC State goes back to the man-to-man defense.
Interesting to see. Miami's been so close and yet not ahead. They never get a lead here. That's going to be a block against Lewis. Swope taking him inside. First foul against Tyler Lewis.
And you get so used to seeing T.J. Warren convert difficult shots. Now, there's pretty good defense there, but Warren almost always converts that one. And the question, as you see Vandenberg try to tip that in, is how did that not go in the basket?
Yeah. Cat Barber checks in for Lewis after the foul was committed. Miami gets a lead here. They gather a lot of momentum because this has really been North Carolina State's game for the most part since the outset. They've not surrendered the lead in quite some time.
And that's a two by LeConte.
And that's the first lead of the night for Miami, 33-32.
And LeConte, that is a very, very good step-back jump shot against the quick Cat Barber. Barber more concerned about LeConte's ability to drive to the basket.
Vandenberg with a dump down to Warren. Well done. The big fella found the player of the year.
But that was not a great pass because it was into traffic and Warren was trapped under the basket. But Warren, with great hands, not only controls the ball, but is able to maneuver himself for 2 points.
Brown alley-ooping here. Caught late by Jacari, and then he throws it into no man's land, and it will end up a turnover back to North Carolina State. Frustration for Jim Larrañaga.
Now that was just one where they should have had a dunk on the play, and they didn't. And T.J. Warren he's a guy who's being guarded, and it's Ryan Brown guarding him, and Brown not looking at the ball.
Turner off the curl.
There you go, Tim. Miami jumps out to that lead, and NC State responds. A basket by Warren on a tough play inside, and then Turner with the three-point shot. Somebody besides Warren has to contribute.
Double Deuce is the guy to keep your eye on the rest of the way. After T.J. Warren, he is the next guy. He'll have opportunities at those types of shots the rest of the evening. And that's a reach by Barber and a foul. Third foul committed by Barber. And you know, Mark Godfrey just pointed that out to the freshman. This just in. You want to play? We need your energy. You've got three.
Just wants Barber to be aware of it. He certainly doesn't want him to slack off on the energy. Nice play by Vandenberg.
Yeah, good hands. Tough shot. Vandenberg almost tipped that one back in. Pulled down by Freeman.
Well, I think Cat Barber missed an opportunity to pitch the ball ahead to T.J. Warren. We've seen how dangerous Warren can be handling the ball in transition.
There it is. This time, the iron on Kai. Pulled down by Jakiri.
I think if you're NC State, Tim, you're going to take that shot 10 times out of 10. Just didn't go down.
Yeah, well, it's going to be there with what they're doing defensively to T.J. Warren. LeConte, tough pass to make in the interior. Turner's on the deck and has it. A scrum ensues, and we've got a tie ball with the arrow to North Carolina State. 13 turnovers committed now. Well, we showed you David Thompson a moment ago. The days of Stormin' Norman, Monty Tau. North Carolina State's championship in 1974. Let's revisit our AT&T fast analysis, and clearly T.J. Warren the focal point.
Well, we're talking about defending T.J. Warren, but T.J. Warren is very hard to guard. He can score in a lot of different ways. He was 3-for-9 shooting in the first half. He's 3-for-5 in this half, and everything at the basket or going to the basket. And Warren, those are pretty impressive numbers. That's a game for most guys, but remember, we're less than halfway through the second half, and Warren is a guy who's scored 30 or more points in 4 of his last 5 games.
And, Deb, there's no denying he's having to work as hard, if not harder, tonight than in any other time I've seen.
You know, guys, I spoke to T.J. Warren about being named Player of the Year, and he's very humble. He deferred to his teammates and the coaching staff. But he told me he's prepared for all the attention that he has garnered this year on the court because he conditioned himself for these moments. He lost 30 pounds in the offseason. He even took leadership classes. He leads by example, not by a lot of words.
Yeah, he's a great player, Tony Warren. Turner comes up empty this time with a little in-between game. Warren takes it away. With hit larceny and a deuce. Wow, that's why you're Player of the Year, right there.
And that's now 8 steals in the game for NC State. Warren with 20 points. And the Wolfpack defense continues to be the key element in this game.
I can't imagine why there was any debate about whether he deserved to be Player of the Year or not. I cannot imagine why. Air ball, and Vandenberg got a big mitt on it last. It's out of bounds, control to Miami.
There's debate because there's debate about everything. Turner misses the shot, and Warren, he just keeps going after it. He refuses to believe that they're going to lose the ball. He takes it, drives it to the basket, knocks it down. That's where we have seen him tonight at his best, at the basket or going to the basket.
Well, I'm not one of those pundits or commentators that had a vote in the ACC Player of the Year category or first or second team, but I'll tell you this. He would have been a runaway freight train choice for me if I'd had one.
Well, I did have one, and I voted for him, so I guess I'm okay with you.
How about that? And an answer by Reed. Yeah, the freshman from Princeton Day School in Ewing, New Jersey, puts it down, his first bucket, and it's 39-35.
again, we talked about this before the game, with Miami really needing a big offensive effort from a number of different guys.
Warren reads the double team right to Vandenberg. Count it and a foul. He's doing it all. Dropping dimes, leaving change, and forcing defenders to change their pants.
It is one thing to be able to see the double team and sense it come, but it's another thing for his teammate to come right down through the lane. The other guy who recognized it was Jordan Vandenberg. And Vandenberg, that is a great play. He sees they double team Warren. He sees it's his guy who is creating the double team, and he goes and finds the open spot. That is a really nice play by the big man.
First 3 points of the night for Vandenberg, who has just quietly gone about the business of being a factor in the North Carolina State front line this year.
And Miami's got to be careful here. The game is very close to getting away from them. They need some baskets.
Yeah, Swope has not been as active, Dan. Brown hangs a three. That will help matters for Larrañaga's bunch, 42-38.
Brown has really, really good range on that three-point shot, and Freeman just refused to come out and guard him.
How about the way he responded from being the seventh option to the top option in a single year's time, Ryan Brown? Turner being checked by LeConte. Nothing really Manu could do other than commit the personal, and he did.
Ryan Brown is a guy who needs to be able to step up, and he just looks Freeman right in the eye. Says, okay, if you're not going to come out and guard me, I can make this shot.
Oh, a little sleep action there by Ryan Brown, and Cat Barber quickly got inside him and forced the foul from Ryan Brown. That's his third. So just that quickly, we've had a third foul picked up by LeConte, and Ryan Brown gets his third. So the issues that Jim Larrañaga mentioned at halftime to Dev Antonelli could come to fruition here with foul difficulty down the stretch. And Georgia Tech and Clemson. That'll be a defensive battle coming up in our nightcap. Turner, in between game, but this one goes crying off the front rim. Another chance. Count it. 44-38, 11 in the game for Turner. He averages 10 on the season.
For Miami, I think you really have to dig in on the defensive end. And Tim, I think your point about Miami trying to play from in front is really a key. It's hard to make a comeback when you've got a guy like TJ Warren who can put such pressure on the defense that other NC State players are likely to get pretty good looks.
Well, Swope got the ball, but he quickly gave it right back to Ryan Brown. The shot clock is down to 10.
NC State, after early in the game struggling with it, they've really made Swope drive the ball with his left hand, and he's not quite as good finishing going in that direction.
Akabajori comes down with a rebound. I think TJ Warren got caught reaching in. He did. That's his second. Five team fouls now committed by North Carolina State.
That was sort of just a giveaway right there. TJ Warren, I think, trying to be aggressive. Akpajori was a little bit passive.
Early in the season, TJ had some problems being too aggressive on defense and not understanding time and score, and he fouled out of a number of games, close games that NC State might have otherwise won. He's played far better the second half of the season defensively. Ryan Brown again. Well, the two best players on the floor are making the difference for their teams offensively here in the second half.
And it's very important that Ryan Brown be the guy to step up in a situation where Miami's struggling to score.
They are maintaining contact, though, only down four. Turner, a step back three.
And he was intent on taking that three-point shot. The first Miami defensive effort took it away, and he just let the defensive player slide by and stepped right back and did it again.
He is the guy they were counting on to be this year's Scott Wood. Reed can't get it to go. Turner was on the baseline out of bounds. Miami will have it. Ralston Turner, all smiles, and why not? He has 14-8 NC State. Back after these words from your local stations. A quick look at our Valero game summary. Ryan Brown and TJ Warren, two guys that they lean on most, are getting the job done on the offensive end of the floor. But the story of late has been Ralston Turner. As we suggested, the second option wears 2-2, but he hits a lot of threes as well.
And it's very good for North Carolina State that they have a second option, because Turner is a guy, he's got 5 field goals. T.J. Warren has 7 field goals, so between the two of them, they have a total of 12 of the 18 field goals, and the officials, Tim, are looking to see if Turner's toe was on the line on that last 3-point shot. He just showed it. Under the rules this year, the officials don't stop the game immediately until the last 4 minutes of the game or in the overtime period. But what they do is they wait till the next TV timeout, and that's what we have now. So they're checking to see if Warren's toe was on the line on that last play.
I wanted to make mention of this because I know, Dan, that you just recently left an NCAA tournament seminar, and we're discussing some of the points of emphasis and rules changes in college basketball with John Adams, who's in charge of the NCAA tournament.
And this is what they're looking at. Is his foot on the line? Right there, they're trying to see if his foot is on the line. Now, what happens is they make a call, and they called it a 3. And then when they go over to look at the monitor, they have to find indisputable video evidence that their call was wrong. And that looked really close to me. I don't think they have enough to reverse that call, and that's what they've decided. It stays 47-40.
It remains a 3, and it is 47-40. One of the things I wanted to mention, that the idea that you can now go in the last couple of minutes and check who last touched the ball, that is a change in this year's NCAA tournament, and during the regular season a change. And it came from the NCAA tournament game played between Miami and Illinois, where a disputed play really was significant in Miami's holding on and winning. There is a foul underneath, spotted by the officials. It goes against Ralston Turner, his second.
Tim, you are correct in stating that rule, but it's important to point out that that only applies in the last 2 minutes of the game and the last 2 minutes of an overtime period.
And Mike Jaminski and I had that game. It was in Austin, Texas. And Illinois was in a position to pull off one of the grand upsets in the early rounds of last year's NCAAs. And a disputed call, they couldn't do it, couldn't go back and look at it. Had they would have found that, in fact, Miami had touched the ball last, and Illinois would have had a possession. And Miami went on to win the game and get all the way to the Sweet 16. They're 9 of 11 at the stripe, the Canes, and they trail by 5.
And they continue to hang around. North Carolina State, they've had a 6-0 run in this half. They've had a 7-0 run in this half, but they just can't put Miami away.
Really have to admire the way this Miami team's been put together and managed to win.
You've got to be kidding me with that play.
Well, Warren's unreal.
You've got to be kidding me. That was a behind-the-back dribble in traffic, taking it into more traffic, taking it up over a guy who's 7 feet tall and still knocking it in.
And he has 22, does Warren. Reed. Well, they leave wide open Jaquiri. And he knows what to do with it. He has 6.
He has been a project at Miami, but he is improving. You know, this is a kid who was so raw. When he came to the United States from Nigeria, one of his favorite things to do was turn on the water faucets and just let the water run, because in Nigeria he had to carry whatever water he was going to use.
Ralston Turner, off that curl, had missed a couple of those runners, but he got that one to go.
Turner carrying the water for North Carolina State in the second half, certainly.
16 points for him now.
Boy, Reed looked up just in time. Warren almost had that one.
Brown.
Boy, and Brown, you got to be impressed with the way Brown makes big shot after big shot.
Oh, another near steal. Ryan Kersey's on top of it. It goes to Miami. Last touch by Lenard Freeman.
And Cat Barber and Lenard Freeman just a little nonchalant getting that ball in bounds, and Garius Adams recognizes and creates a turnover. Barber just not paying enough attention, and watch Garius Adams. He continues to go after the ball, and because he hustles after there, eventually it goes off Freeman. Boy, you got to pay more attention than that.
That's Warren, his third. And that giveaway foul a moment ago could come into play late if, in fact, another foul is picked up. That's the 7th team foul against the Wolfpack.
Wilson, you got 25.
Adams
is at the free throw line. We touched on it a little bit earlier, but we've not heard much from Swope. It's been Ryan Brown for the most part carrying the freight offensively for Miami here in the second half. Closed captioning for ACC basketball is provided by Bojangles, famous chicken and biscuits. It's bow time.
Leave the
Stony McCreary bus was a Bojangles bus, if memory serves me correctly, from last night. I was stalking the bus last night.
I think you were stalking more than just the bus.
I love my country music. He got some NC State swag, as I understand it. Got to eat with the team. Pre-game meal before setting sail for Austin, Texas, where he's performing tonight. Warren lost it that time. Freeman tries to reclaim it. Swope finally comes out of there with it for Miami.
Boy, Swope is just so strong. He gets anywhere near the ball, he's going to grab it.
And-go maneuver by Adams. Leaves it for Jaquiri, but Vandenberg was quickly in front of him, and he had to give it up to Reed. Nice screen. Turns into a ball screen and a two-pointer to make it 51-50. Just like that, Miami a bucket away from gathering their second lead of the night. Mark Gottfried, sensing trouble, gets a timeout.
One of the problems that North Carolina State has had is in the last few possessions, they've had to make tough shots. And you talk about a tough shot behind the back dribble, takes it into Jaquiri, so he takes it into a crowd and is still able to knock it down. Miami, on the other hand, has been doing a nice job getting open opportunities. You remember early in the game, they weren't making them from the perimeter. Well, recently, particularly the last four or five possessions, they've been making some perimeter shots. And Miami's made their last four field goals as part of a 6-0 run.
Georgia Tech and Clemson are coming up. The official ACC mobile app presented by Outback Steakhouse offers live ACC Network games, video scores, stats, news. Visit acc.com/apps to download. And be sure to check out the basketball championship pages where you can enter to win Outback dinner packages for a year. Two lucky fans will be awarded today, so download the app and enter now.
Occasionally, Dan, when a player is as good as T.J. Warren, makes those wonderful individual plays, guys can become spectators and just expect 22 to, or 24 to make a play. And I'm thinking that may be what Mark Gottfried had in mind during the timeout. And get other guys involved. Tyler Lewis in after the timeout, who can distribute the ball and score the ball. Comes up empty that time. Not an outstanding year shooting the ball from downtown.
He's only a 22% three-point shooter, so if you're Miami, you're very satisfied that Lewis is going to take that shot, particularly coming in cold off the bench.
Adams, that's going to be a block against Tyler Lewis. Second foul on Tyler. Here's Ryan Brown. His efforts not unnoticed here in the second half.
Brown did a great job in the first half getting the ball to the basket, and in the second half he has continued his ability to drive the ball to the basket, but he's also knocked down some outside shots, and his ability to stretch that defense by knocking down a couple of jumpers I think has been a big factor.
Big miss at the stripe for Adams, and a quick foul given up by Swope.
Boy, and that's really difficult, because if you make both of those, you take the lead, but instead you miss the front end of the one-on-one, and you just can't do that in a close game.
16 foul for Miami. One more, and NC State will be in the bonus.
Ryan Brown really making a big effort against Turner.
And it's Reed on Warren.
Now, this is a part of the game where maybe you want to get Washington involved. So much attention is being paid to Warren. Oh, my, that's...
Yeah, into a lot of traffic
there. That was a force.
Well done by Miami defensively. Reed, a transition three, gives Miami the lead by two.
And Reed is a very, very good three-point shooter.
That's the first two-point lead of the night for Miami. They've led by one at one point, 33-32, and now by two, 53-51. Wow,
lot of standing around for North Carolina State, waiting for some big-time play from number 24.
And another turnover. Oh, and he lost sense of where he was on the floor. Boy, Adams, you gotta know when you steal the ball where the sidelines are located. But it's been a nice comeback for Miami, staying close and finally getting ahead by a deuce.
Miami on a 9-0 run, and Tim, in the first half where they attacked NC State by driving the ball to the basket, during this run, they have been making jump shots, not necessarily threes, but they've done a nice job from two-point range, and then in transition, they finally do get a three. Remember, we talked about all hands. Well, yeah. Kanye Jaquiri has made a couple of field goals now. Davon Reed has come off the bench. He scored a couple of field goals, and that has really helped the cause. Reed has 9 points in the game, and he's the second leading scorer.
It hasn't really been a spurt necessarily. It's been more like a percolator, slow drip, drip, drip over a 6 minute, 40 second span, this 9-0 run. And Turner, taking it into the paint, draws the foul. And that's, again, one of the items that I'm sure Mark Godfrey had in mind. Jaquiri picks up his third. Get to the free throw line. And certainly have the offensive scoring punch to force Miami to foul you.
Be sure to stay around between games for the Principal Financial Group at the break. Interviews, highlights, and so much more with our own Mike Hogwood and Corey Alexander.
Turner now has 17 points in the game, 22 points for TJ Warren. So those two guys basically have been the offense. And while you certainly need contributions from them down the stretch, you just get the idea that somebody else is going to have to make a couple of baskets for North Carolina State if they're going to pull this one out.
Well, you made a point earlier about Washington. Maybe he's one. Vandenberg and or Freeman could be another. Complementary players, perhaps.
Freeman is more a defender and rebounder and screener than he is an offensive player. Barber is a guy who can get you some offense taking the ball to the basket.
Washington is out of the game now. Brown with a turnaround. Can't get it to go. TJ Warren with the rebound. We're tied at 53. 8 rebounds in the game for Warren. So he's a couple shy of a double-double, and Mark Godfrey wants a timeout. 2:33 remaining. The ACC and your local Toyota dealers are unlocking the ACC archives, where you can relive over 90 classic games all for free. Jimmy V wins his second and final ACC tournament. The Wolfpack defeating number one seeded, number two nationally ranked North Carolina 68-67. Tournament MVP Vinny Delnegro hitting a couple of free throws in the final 14 seconds to put the Wolfpack on top. Never forget that one at the Cap Center in Landover. Visit the ACC.com/vault, brought to you by Toyota. Let's go places. Dan, in 1987, two of the great semifinal games ever played back-to-back, Virginia and North Carolina, and North Carolina State and Wake Forest. Bob Stack was coaching, and, of course, Jimmy V and Bob went way back. He actually coached Bob in his earliest days, a freshman coach. And those two games were just stellar. Charles Shackelford was one of the stars in that game for North Carolina State. Warren gets it to go.
Well, he's so quick. Reed was not in bad position, and Jaquiri was there to try to help, but Jaquiri just couldn't get over in time.
55-53, and Jim Larrañaga wants a timeout.
That's one of those plays where I think you got to try to double-team Warren, but he made the move so quickly, they couldn't get it. What happens is the side is cleared, and I think if you're Garius Adams, you have to drop down immediately and make Warren give up the ball. If you give Warren that much time to stand there, look here, nobody coming down to double team. He makes that one quick dribble and gets the shot up high on the backboard.
One of the things Mark Godfrey set out to do right away when he took this job was assemble an outstanding staff. There's Derek Wittenberg in there, of course, one of the stars for Jim Valvano's national championship team. But Bobby Lutz is a former head coach at Charlotte. Orlando Early, a former head coach at ULM, had been with Mark at Alabama as an assistant, and Rob Moxley all together. Jim Herrick, though, still has his footprints well within Mark Godfrey's head. He's always been a mentor of his.
his days as an assistant with Steve Lavin.
That sounds uncomfortable, Tim.
Yeah. It does. What happens when you ad-lib your way through a quick memory?
A footprint in the head. That requires the foot to be in the head.
That's been my problem for years.
Well, your foot's in the mouth.
That's true. Swope is in the game. Arias Adams trying to dribble through a double team, loses it to Barber. Not a wise choice. I think the foot was somewhere up near the noggin there.
Well, that was a bad play. I think that they expected Swope to catch that ball and just power it to the basket, but good help by NC State.
Look out! Look out! Ralston Turner has 21.
Now, in every situation so far tonight when Miami has desperately needed a basket, Ryan Brown is the guy to whom they've gone.
That turnover by Adams really, really hurt Miami's effort there. Brown gives it back up to Adams, looking to atone, and he's fouled by Warren, and that's four. With 1:20 to play, and this is, again, an example of what has happened to Mark Gottfried's team in many games with TJ. He's so aggressive, and he doesn't know when to back off. That is a foul they're always going to call, a reach.
The interesting thing is, normally you'd like to take Warren off Adams and put him on Davon Reed, but Reed has been so active that you run a similar fouling risk no matter who Warren is.
Canes are now 12 of 16 at the line. Those were a couple of big misses late after having a pretty good night at the stretch.
That's two consecutive misses on the front end of a 1-1 in a tight game.
And Cat Barber is fouled by Adams.
Turner has been a guy who's had a big game all night, and he just gets off the screen and the defender can't get back in time, and the key there is the quick release. Ryan Brown gets close, but he just can't get close enough.
State is 9 of 11 at the stripe tonight. Harbor has really improved as the season's prolonged as a free throw shooter. But he really didn't want the ball late in games because he struggled at the stripe early in the season. I think it was one of the reasons he gave up the ball against Syracuse. Vandenberg got the offensive rebound and then was fouled by Jacquari. Or was it Reed? It was Reed that got the foul rather than Jacquari.
Jim Larrinagas saw his guys trail and come all the way back and take the lead, but you really have to credit North Carolina State with hanging tough and responding.
Well, we talked about guys that besides Turner or Warren that might make a play. Vandenberg just did by getting that rebound and even one of those two to go. Make it a 7-point game. Now NC State with a 9-0 run of their own. Brown. Freeman had it but lost it. Out of bounds, last touched by Reed. NC State gets it back with 57 seconds left, and Warren's fourth foul now doesn't look so bad or so devastating to Wolfpack fans. Tyler Lewis will also check back in.
Ryan Brown has made some big shots tonight, but that was awfully deep, awfully fast. Of course, they're down three possessions. That's the importance of that one free throw that Vandenberg made. You've got to go quickly.
Warren in the open floor, giving it up to Turner. Wisely waiting for the foul, and it comes from Reed. Fourth foul on Devon Reed.
As we just saw on the last free throw attempt by North Carolina State, it's very important for Miami to block out. If they miss, they need to get the rebound.
One timeout taken by Miami. 50.5 remaining. NC State looking for that shot at Syracuse. They're also on the same side of the bracket as Duke. And among the teams that are looking to vie for an opportunity as an at-large into the NCAAs, no one has a better draw than does North Carolina State. Get a chance at Syracuse and Duke. Those are two top 10 RPI teams. This is what's coming up next. Georgia Tech and Clemson immediately following our game. We'll go between games with our friends Mike Hogwood and Corey Alexander. And then the Tigers and the Jackets will get at it.
First, Tim, you're talking about Syracuse, and this is what awaits the winner of this game. And keep in mind that Syracuse and North Carolina State played a heck of a game up at Syracuse. It's one of those games when Syracuse was still undefeated and had that miraculous ending after miraculous ending to maintain their undefeated status before their loss to Boston College.
I talked with a few committee members of the NCAA selection committee this past week, and they are sequestered in Indianapolis and have been since Tuesday of this week. They are keeping a very watchful eye on a number of teams that are trying to crack through the bubble, and NC State is one of them. Because of the opportunities that they have on this side of the bracket, Syracuse, provided you win that one, Duke, it's right there for the taking, but that's a large bite to take off if you're going to get to the NCAA tournament.
So they're sequestered in Indianapolis, and it's Sunday at about 6 Eastern time when we'll see the white smoke from the NCAA building, right?
Well, the events of this day, particularly over in the Big East, where Villanova just got knocked off the one line, losing to Seton Hall at the buzzer, plus St. John's lost to Providence today. That, you could make a case, was a playoff game for the opportunity to be in at large. And Cooley's team got a win.
Tim, the important thing to remember is that nobody's been announced as in.
That's right.
And there's still an awful lot of basketball left to be played. Teams still have opportunities, and the way you cash in on your opportunities is to win games, and NC State has put themselves in great position to win this one.
That's all you can control.
That's right. Too much time.
Yeah, LeCott. Up there, Swoop, another offensive rebound. That's been his game. Staying with it, but can't get it to go. Outlet for Desmond Lee, and it is showtime. He was actually more subtle with that than I thought he'd be. Ryan Brown is fouled, and he'll get to the line. Great comeback on his part. Did not give up on it.
Tim, I think subtlety is the key word right here, because in that situation, if you're going to shoot that ball, whether you shoot a layup or a dunk or anything else, you better put it in the basket.
Yep.
And that was a nice drive by Brown, and if you're North Carolina State, you don't want to foul, but even if he makes this free throw, it's still a three-possession game. Key for the Wolfpack now is to secure the rebound and make some free throws.
You know, what's missing from that resume for Mark Gottfried is a number of impact wins. Probably the Pitt game on the road was their best within conference, as a quick foul is given up. And it'll go against Ryan Brown, against Desmond Lee. And this is just what the doctor ordered to get this win and then have another shot at Syracuse and Duke. Jim Larrañaga, though, I got to give him a lot of credit, Dan, to manufacture this kind of team in short order with the sanctions that came his way in the aftermath of the Nevin Shapiro mess. And they have stockpiled some really gifted talent and transfers to step right in next year. Lots been mentioned about Angel and McClellan being ready to go. Miami will be back and very competitive again very soon with a lot of new faces that have experience next season.
You really have to go quickly and you need a three.
Brown grazing the front iron. Lee with a run out to Barber.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Score will not be indicative of how competitive it really was. Miami had a 9-0 run, got a lead, and then North Carolina State answered with one of their own to put the game away. The Wolfpack in the 61st edition of the Atlantic Coast Conference Tournament, one that is so steep in tradition with that institution, comes away with a much-needed win over Miami, ending on a 16-5 run. And
and will play Syracuse tomorrow night at 7 Eastern time in what should be a fun basketball game.
Tim, I don't think there's any question about that. We just talked about the game that they played in the Carrier Dome, which went right down to the end, and I think that's what we're going to see here. And you think there'll be a few North Carolina State fans in the arena?
Yeah, well, I think you go back to the way that game ended. A lot of residue in the aftermath. The foul that maybe could have been or wasn't, a continuation that was or wasn't. Say what you want about all of that. But North Carolina State had the ball, and if they had simply been fouled at the end of the game as opposed to turned it over, they quickly turned the ball over, enabling Syracuse a chance for a run out and a layup to win the game. Syracuse actually stole that game away from NC State at home. This is, I'm sure, the team they would most like to play. Well, let's go over to Deb with TJ Warren.
All right, Tim, thank you. TJ, it's been a busy week for you, named Player of the Year. How did you keep your focus for this game?
My teammates have been giving me a lot of encouragement, a lot of positivity. I just want to stay with it tonight. We were lucky to get the win.
TJ, you get the box in one. You get the triangle in two. You draw all kinds of attention. They face guard you, yet you still find a way to score. How?
My teammates, I do a good job of getting open, and they find me in the open floor as well as half-court set. So a lot of credit to my teammates for that.
When Ralston Turner plays the way he plays and makes some big shots down the stretch, how does that help you guys win?
We're real dangerous. When Ralston's hitting that three, we're real dangerous. I feel like we could beat anybody in this conference when he's hitting that shot like that.
TJ, you got Syracuse next. You had a one-point loss up there in the Carrier Dome. What are your thoughts on playing them?
We're just going to have a lot of energy and come out aggressive and just get the win.
Thanks, TJ.
Thanks.
All right, Tim.
All right, Deb, thank you. TJ Warren, 24 points, 8 rebounds. Got lots of help from Ralston Turner, who aided with 22 of his own. We'll be back in just a moment. Stay right where you are. 67-58, North Carolina State, the winner in game one of our evening session. In second round action, along with Dan Bonner, Tim Brando, and well, that was entertaining. It was fun. I love the ebb and flow of the second half, and Miami just sticking with it to give themselves a chance. But ultimately, North Carolina State had too many answers in Warren and Turner.
We talked about big players and big plays, and Ryan Brown certainly made some big plays for Miami to put them in a position. But in the end, the big plays were made. The biggest plays were made by North Carolina State. TJ Warren had 24, and Turner had 22, so they had 46 points between them. It was basically Warren from the inside, Turner from the outside, and when they needed baskets, they got them, and when they needed defensive stops, they got them, and they were able to push the ball out. Some easy plays here. This lead with the dunk, that gave them a 10-point lead. Just too much for Miami to overcome.
As we look at the brackets, I want to ask you something about knowing who you're playing next and having recently played them, which is the case for NC State against Syracuse, okay? You know you're going to get zoned. You know the responsibilities and the changes that are made in terms of what you do offensively against it. Is that an advantage for North Carolina State, given that they recently played them, had some success at the Carrier Dome, and they know that's what Boeheim's going to run? There's no deviating from that.
Well, it may be an advantage, but remember, Syracuse played in that game, too, and they won the game.
So yes, they did.
They're very familiar with what North Carolina State is going to do. I just think that those brackets indicate that we have a setup for a really good quarterfinal Friday.
Yeah.
There's going to be some outstanding basketball played in here tomorrow.
That's right.
All day tomorrow.
All day tomorrow with Mike and Tim early in the day, and Corey is going to come down here and join me. I'm tired of you. he's going to come down and join me tomorrow night. And with that in mind, we need a break. We need some time apart, Bonner and myself. And we'll take that, get a cooler hot pop, and let Hogwood and Corey Alexander go to work. At the break, we'll be back for Georgia Tech and Clemson.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Food Lion, official supermarket of the ACC. By Geico, official corporate champion of the ACC. By BB&T, official bank of the ACC, member FDIC. By Toyota, official corporate champion of the ACC. And by AT&T, official wireless provider of the ACC.
Yeah, a lot going on at Fan Fest just next door to the Greensboro Coliseum. We welcome you now to the Principal Financial Group at the break. Back in the Coliseum, Mike Hogwood, Corey Alexander with you now. And Corey, first of all, I want to give Miami some credit. Final minutes, they come back to tie this game at 53, and then NC State took care of business.
Well, Miami, of course, is a veteran team, and when you think about what they do, they have a number of guys that can attack the basket, and they were able to do that, and Ryan Brown made a number of big shots, but NC State stepped it up defensively, and that was really the key to this game. And you talk about T.J. Warren and Ross Turner both putting up their jersey numbers, but Cat Barber, two big steals, seven assists, zero turnovers. He was big for the Pack. The numbers don't show us scoring, but he was big for the Pack at the end of that game. Yeah.
Now, we just heard T.J. Warren with Debbie Antonelli talk about when Ross Turner is hitting it from outside, they can beat anybody in the league, and it certainly looked like that tonight, and he had a great game.
He did, and we had an opportunity to see him get off, and he made all five of the NC State three-point field goals. He was the only one from State to knock down one from behind the arc, but he became that complimentary scorer to T.J. Warren and had a huge night here in the ACC tournament.
Yeah, he was a difference maker tonight. We'll take a look now at the final stats in this game. Look at the points off of turnovers, would you?
That was the biggest key for NC State. They were able to get out in transition. Cat Barber, T.J. Warren, both those guys doing a great job just taking the basketball away from Miami. And Miami, with 15 turnovers, was the difference in this game. And you look at that, NC State handled the ball well, and they shot 60% in the second half, and that's a key to success.
Ralston Turner, 22 points. And a moment ago, Debbie Antonelli caught up with him.
Ralston, congratulations on the win. When TJ gets all that attention, why is it so important for you to be able to make shots?
I think it's important because, first of all, you know, everybody knows TJ is a great player. But he can't score all the points. You know, he can't make all the defensive plays. He can't win by himself. So the main thing for the rest of us is we just need to make sure that we can give him some help. And, you know, that's really all that we try to do tonight.
Where do you get the confidence to take the big shots when the game's on the line?
I think it's just practice. You know, I shoot that shot all the time. And, you know, it's just like practice. If you tell yourself that, then you can shoot in any situation.
It kind of felt like a home crowd in here. It's going to feel like that tomorrow when you play Syracuse. What's going to be important for you guys to do to win?
I think we just have to make plays. And, you know, they have a lot of great players. So, obviously, we have to contain them. And we have to do a good job attacking their zone.
And in attacking their zone, what are a couple of key things that you must do offensively?
Well, I think you got to get inside the zone. That's the most big important thing. And you also got to make some shots. So I think with a combination of that and getting rebounds, then I think we might have a chance to win.
Thanks, Ralston.
Thank you.
All right, that was Ralston Turner. Reminder, folks, that it's Happy Hoops Days at the ACC Digital Network. You can count on Jeff Fischel and Drew Barry to bring you all the best highlights and must-see moments at the ACC DN or visit theacc.com. It's the ACC Digital Network, brought to you by Ruby Tuesday. Happy Hoops Day. Big win for NC State. They're ready to take on Syracuse tomorrow on quarterfinal Friday. And we will be back to talk more about the big win tonight by the NC State Wolfpack.